your space, notice what's going on in your bodies this morning, how you feel,
what's going on in there.
Slow down the breath. And be aware of the breath without paying over attention to it. So being attached to nothing, except perhaps your dog that's licking your head. And completely surrendering yourself onto your mats. If you can, take your hands out in front, take a prayer, and bring a prayer to the nape of the neck. Set an intention for this morning's practice. Perhaps sending some good vibrations out into the universe, into the community, inhale, stretch the arms back out in front of you. Walk over to the right side. Place your left hand on top of the right. Reach a little bit longer. Push your hips to your heels. Relax neck and shoulders. And then creep your left hand a little bit further over to the right side so the arms are actually crossed, maybe at the elbows, maybe not so far. And from this position, come back to sitting on your heels as you wrap your arms into eagle. Lift the arms up, lift the chest up. Exhale, bring your chin into your chest. Inhale, lift the arms up, lift the heart up. Release the bind of the arms, stretch the arms all the way up overhead. Exhale, place the hands down on the floor, push the hips back towards your heels. Inhale, walk over to your left side, right hand on top of left. Push the hips back to your heels. And then take the top arm and move it a little further over to the side. So you're crossing it, maybe the elbows, maybe higher, maybe lower. Inhale, come back to center. Keep the arms crossed as you take them into a double bind, perhaps. Lift the arms up, eagle arms. Exhale, chin down. Relax the neck and shoulders. Maybe point the fingers forward. Inhale, bring the arms up. Open up the arms, release it. Exhale, back to your child's pose. Walk your hands forward, hips back. Inhale, hands and knees. Tuck your toes. And stretch the right leg back. Release the knee and switch legs. Just taking a few moments to release the pressure in the knees. One more time on each side. And then come back to your center. Hands under shoulders, knees under hips. Arch your back through your belly. Exhale, chin to chest, round and curl. Push the earth away. Let your head come down to the floor. Inhale, dip your belly, arch your back, tuck your toes, broaden your body, broaden your collarbones. Exhale, round and curl. Inhale to neutral, walk your hands out in front of you. Drop your chin chest to the floor. Nice big stretch with the front of your shoulders and chest. Inhale. Exhale. Good. Maybe wag your tail a little bit even. One more breath. Let's go ahead and take that all the way down to the floor as you shift yourself forward. Come onto your bellies. Outstretch your arms in front of you. Come onto the pads of your fingertips. Drop your shoulders back and down and push your pubic bone into the earth. Lift your chest up. So we're just creating a long line from fingertip to toes. Exhale, come on down. Walk your hands back under your shoulders. Inhale, low cobra. Elbows squeeze in so you don't have to lift anything but your chest off the floor. You don't even have to get that high. Exhale, come down to the floor. Walk your hands back another handprint. Inhale, lift your chest. Keep your hips down. Squeeze the elbows in by your side. Exhale, come down. Now, yogi's choice, upward dog, or maybe take a bow. It might be early for some, but for some, you might want to go there. So lift your heart, lift your legs. You choose where you want to go. One more breath. Good. Exhale, come to the floor, everybody. All push back to your heels, child's pose. Sit on your heels, stretch your arms forward, and reach your hips back. Inhale to hands and knees one more time. Exhale, tuck your toes, Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Inhale on your tippy toes, bend your right knee, lower your left heel to the floor. Inhale on your toes, bend your left knee, right heel to the floor. Inhale on your toes, both heels towards the floor, chest to thighs, let your head go. Good, stay for another breath as you walk your feet forward on the next breath. Right hand, not all the way, excuse me, just a step or two. Right hand to your left ankle and twist. Breathe in, breathe out. Release the right hand, switch sides. Left hand, right ankle, shin or foot, look under the arm. Good, release the hands. Press your weight back towards your heels, soften your knees, and walk your hands back to your feet. Come onto your fingertips, lengthen your spine. Exhale, fold your body in half and let your head hang down. Shift your weight into the balls of your feet. You don't need to lift your heels, just stay in a forward fold. Inhale to your fingertips, floor block or shins. And then everybody place your hands on your shins if they're not. Crown of the head to tailbone nice and long. Lead with your heart, hands to your hips. Now rise up to stand. Place your hands on your back, tuck your tailbone underneath you, lift your heart up. Exhale, come back to stand. Heel toe your feet together. Bring your arms up overhead, inhale. Exhale, right arm under left once or twice. Bind it, lift your heart. Exhale, bend your knees, twist to the right side. Inhale, come back to standing into the center. Exhale, twist and bend to the left side. So you're in a squat or a chair. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, release your arms, stretch them overhead. Interlace your fingers, turn the palms inside out, upside down. Drop your ribs down towards your hips. And lift up and backwards, as much as or as little as you want. If you need more support, put your hands on your back. One more breath. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, arms down by your side. Left arm under right once or twice, lift your heart. Inhale, lean back. Exhale, bend your knees outside of left leg. Inhale to center. Exhale to the outside of the right leg, knees bent. Inhale to center. Lift your heart. Exhale, release. Interlace your fingers, one finger over from the last time. Lift your arms up, ribs down, lift your heart. Maybe you lean back, maybe you stay supported on your back. Good. Now, while your arms are here, separate your feet hips width apart. Exhale, open the arms and fold. Hands to floor, shins or blocks, look forward, inhale. Walk one arm print out, keep your weight back in your heels. Inhale, halfway lift. Walk your arms out, another hand print. Exhale, you may still be on your fingers or maybe not yet, Svanasana. Inhale, look forward, walk another hand print out, keep walking until you're in your downward facing dog. Adjust your body, side to side, front and back. Bring your feet a little closer to touch. Take your right leg in the air, nice and high, soften the knees, square your hips, and look forward. Exhale, knee to nose, nice and slow. Come forward to a high plank, and then step your right foot forward, lower your left knee to the floor. Shifting your weight so that your knee is over the ankle on the right leg, and that you're slightly above your left knee. You're not putting all that weight pressure on top of the knee. And then just shift forward, pull your collarbones back, forward, shoulders back. Inhale, start to stretch forward and back. Introducing some stretch into your hamstrings, bending forward and back a couple times now. Take your time, just find a little bit of sensation in each space before we stay a little bit longer. On the next hamstring stretch, next straight leg, stay over here. Feel free to put your hands on the blocks. Pull the right hip back and lift it forward. Being on your toes or your heels is up to you. Walk your hands back a little further. Good. And then turn your right toes to the right. Just flip the foot, open the hip, and stay and breathe. Notice the sensations, if they change, how they change. One more breath. Good, if your toes are open or your hip is open, come back to center. Re-bend the front knee, walk your hands forward again. Place your hands on the floor or blocks. Shoulders back and down. Breathe in and stretch through that back psoas. Tuck your left toes underneath you. Lift the left knee off the floor. Keep your hips low. Bring your right hand inside of your left foot. Right foot, sorry. And then turn to your left side, however. Spinning it around, coming into a wide-legged forward fold. Hang your head down to the floor. Inhale, halfway up or on a block. Exhale, fold your body in half. Check out that your knees are not going behind your hips. There's a slight bend, perhaps a little bit more weight into the balls of your feet. Now on this inhale, lengthen your spine. Grab your feet on the outside edges and cup your hands underneath your feet. Pull your elbows out to the side. Head down towards the floor, hips up towards the sky. Breathe in. And breathe out. Bringing your chest to your thighs, let go. Inhale. And exhale. One more breath, everybody. Good. Inhale, look forward, pull against your feet, release your grip, place your hands underneath your shoulders, and walk back to the front of your mat. Step back to a downward facing dog, right leg meets left, top of the mat, or back of the mat. Inhale on your toes. Shift your weight forward so your shoulders are over your wrists, maybe even slightly forward. Pull the belly up and in. Press the shoulders open. Look towards the front of your mat. You can lower your knees or go halfway down. Breathe in. Roll over your toes. Upward facing dog or low belly cobra. Downward facing dog, hips up in the air. Bring your feet together. Take your left leg in the air nice and high, soften the right knee. Square your hips. So you might have to bend that right knee a lot to do that. Left knee to chest, round and curl, come forward to the plank. And then step the leg through, lower the opposite knee to the floor so your right knee is on the floor. And just settle in here for a moment. Pull your shoulders back. Breathe into the right side, psoas. And then let's start to make some movement, just subtle movements. Floating back and forth. Couple three times, as they say. Before we hold the hamstring stretch. So come back when you're ready on the next one. Fold over your leg. Maybe walk your hands back or on blocks. You choose if you want to keep your toes up or down. And if you want to maybe roll to the outside edge of the left foot and open it out a little bit differently. Breathe. What do you think about that, Daisy? Breathe in, breathe out. See if you can get your chest closer to your thigh without force. One more breath. Good. So as you come out of this, begin to spin your left. left hand forward, walk your hands back into your low lunge, pull your shoulders back and down. Take a breath here. Good, exhale, tuck your right toes underneath you, lift just the knee, don't lift the hips, stay nice and low. Left hand inside, left leg, we spin to the right side of the mat. Slightly pigeon-toed, fold your body in half. Inhale, halfway lift. Good, exhale, take a hold of your peace finger grip around your big toes. Draw your elbows out to the side and let your head hang down towards the floor. Again, softening the weight in the knees, maybe shifting the weight forward into the balls of the feet. Head comes down. If you'd like to take any inversion from here, feel free to make that your choice. Take another breath. Inhale, release your hands underneath your shoulders, look forward. Walk over to your left side, coming back to your low lunge. Step into your downward facing dog, hips up in the air. Inhale on your toes, come to high plank, look forward. Exhale your way through vinyasa, you either add, skip, or just do your thing. Good, and lift your hips up. Come high on your toes and soften your knees. Make your way to the top of the mat. You can walk, step, jump, hop, fly, your choice. Lengthen your spine. Exhale, fold in half. Inhale, rise to stand, bring the arms with you overhead. Exhale, hands to prayer. Bend your knees, twist outside your right thigh. Sit down and let your knees be level, thumbs to your heart center. Sit a little bit lower so you can keep the levelness in the hips, thumbs to your heart center, and your belly lifts and twists away from your thighs. Take another breath. As you exhale, fold over your legs, then straighten them, head to shins. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, left leg steps all the way back. Low lunge on your right side. Hands on floor or blocks. Bring your collarbones forward, hug your hips towards midline. Inhale and begin to straighten the front leg and take a couple rounds here again. So with the knee off the floor, we're doing similar to what we just did on our with our knee on the floor. When you get to your next straight leg, stay there for a moment. Pull the right hip back. You might have to shorten your stance or keep your knees bent. And again, if you want to spin out onto the outer edge of the right foot, lengthen your spine, fold over your shin. Inhaling and exhaling. Good, come on back to center on the inhale. Rebend your knee, lift your heart, settle in for a breath or two here, shoulders back. And as you exhale, take your right hand inside the foot and spin over to your left side. Turn your toes slightly pigeon, fold your body in half. If you need to grab straps or towels for some shoulder opener, feel free to grab that now. Come halfway up and bring your hands to your hips or your heart. Tuck your tailbone underneath you. Make sure you're not too wide in your stance, but you're not too close either. Inhale the arms out shoulder height. Reach your arms away from each other. So we've done this once or twice today. Take your right arm underneath your left arm. Lift your heart. Maybe do a little back bend here. Maybe do a big back bend. Maybe not do any at all. And as you exhale, come back to center and fold in between your two legs, pointing your fingers and your head down to the floor. Softening the knees as much as you need. Inhale. And exhale. Another breath. Inhale, lengthen your spine. Come up to standing. Keep your hands as they are. Spin your right foot forward. Bring your left foot a little forward, warrior one with eagle arms. So pull the right hip back, left hip forward. Lift your arms up, lift your heart up. Exhale, come inside of your right leg and point your fingers and head towards the earth. Hug your hips towards the center. Breathe in, breathe out. Inhale, back up. Stand up, keep warrior one legs. Exhale, release your arms, bring the arms overhead. Exhale, take your arms behind your back, interlace your fingers, lift your chest. Fold back in between your two legs. Maybe your shoulder goes inside, maybe you need to widen your leg to do that. Just make sure you're not putting tremendous weight on your thigh with your body leaning into it. You're resting on the inside of the thigh or lightly above it. One more breath. Good, release your hands to the floor, either side of the leg. Turn the back foot forward. Step back, three-legged downward dog, right leg in the air, shake it out. Ooh, good morning. Four on the floor, downward dog. Inhale through a plank. Chaturanga, your way. Upward dog, downward dog, hips up. Feet are coming together. Lift the left leg in the air. Step it on through. Bring the right leg to meet at halfway lift. Exhale, fold, rise up to stand. Bring the arms all the way up. Exhale, prayer to heart, twist to the left side. Knees are level, hips are dropped down. Belly lifts off your thighs, hands to your chest or sternum. Sit a little deeper as you exhale. Inhale, come back to center, hands to the floor, then straighten your legs, head down. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, right leg steps back. Hands on floor or blocks. Low lunge. Inhale, straighten front leg. And take a couple rounds there, going back and forth. And on your next straight front leg, we'll stay there. Fold over it. Pull your left hip back, right hip forward. Use blocks where needed, and perhaps you roll out onto the outer left edge of the foot. And breathe. Again, just noticing different sensations when you change, very subtle changes. One more breath. Good. Release the foot to the floor, re-bend the knee, come into a low lunge, bring your heart forward, your shoulders back. Left hand's gonna move inside of left leg as we spin over to the long edge of our mat. Rise up onto your fingertips, halfway lift. Hands to your hips or heart, rise up to stand. Bring your arms up overhead, inhale. Exhale, arms out shoulder height. Reach your fingers in two directions. Inhale, left arm under right once or twice. Arms lift up and back. Exhale down through the center of your body, fingertips towards the floor, weight towards your front of your foot rather than your heels, head down. Inhale and exhale. One more breath. Inhale, rise up. Good, lift your heart. Exhale, arms come right down the midline of your body. Turn your left toes forward, turn your right toes slightly forward, bend your knees, warrior three with your eagle arms. So you might have to adjust your feet a little bit wider on your mat. You might have to lengthen them a little bit on your mat. See where you're at, inhale, lift your heart. Exhale, fold inside of your left leg, fingertips reach towards the floor, hug your hip to midline, breathe, let your head go. Keep hugging that left hip in towards midline. Make sure you're not collapsing your body weight on your thigh. One more breath. Rising up with your arms in warrior, in eagle, with warrior, one legs. Exhale, release your arms, stretch them up overhead. Inhale, release the arms, one finger over and behind your back. Knuckles down, chest up. Exhale, lean again inside of your thigh. Head down, arms up, and just snuggle everything closer together. Inhale and exhale. One more breath. Good. As you exhale, release your hands to the floor. Spin your right hip forward. Good. And step three-legged dog, left leg in the air. Hold it up and kick it out, shake it out, get rid of the tension. Release your feet to the floor, chest to your thighs. Inhale, come forward for your vinyasa. Take it, don't take it. Add to it. You do you. And everybody else will do that. Breathe in. breathe out. Rise up onto your tippy toes. Soften your knees, look at your hands, walk, step, float, hop, fly on the top, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Bring your feet together, bend your knees, lengthen your spine, sit into chair pose, arms up and out. Drop your seat a little bit lower, and then inhale, rise all the way to standing. Hands to your heart center, arms by your side. Surya Namaskar, B. Inhale, bend the knees. Sweep the floor, chair pose, Utkatasana. Exhale, fold, head to shins, toes, or lift straight. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, bend your knees, plant your palms, step, step, jump, hop, fly, chaturanga, as many as you choose. Upward dog, downward dog. Left foot turns, right foot steps. Warrior one, arms up, one breath here. Exhale, flow through your chaturanga, upward and downward facing dogs. Hips up in the air. Right foot turns, left foot steps, warrior one, inhale, take it up. Exhale, let it go. Breathe in and empty. Inhale, exhale, stay in down dog. Inhale. And exhale. Rise high on your toes, bend your knees. Look towards the top of your mat, walk, step, hop, fly. Float to the top, halfway lift. Exhale, fold, head to shins. Inhale, bend your knees, sweep the floor, Utkatasana. Reach up. Hands to prayer, arms by your side. Inhale, bend your knees, sweep floor. Utkatasana, chair pose. Exhale, forward fold, let it go. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, step to the back, chaturanga, your way. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Left foot turns, right foot steps, warrior one, arms up, rise up. Empty on the way down, keep the breath through your push-up. And then inhale into your back bend. Exhale into your downward dog. Right foot turns, left foot forward. Warrior one, arms up, take the breath. And then take the entire breath to get through your push-up. Inhale on your way back into your back bend. Exhale, downward dog, hips up. Stay and breathe. Inhale. And exhale. One more breath. Good, now just step, turn your left foot forward, step your right foot forward. Warrior one, draw that right hip in, rise up, inhale. Exhale, glide into warrior two, facing the left side of your mat. Reach your fingers in two directions. Inhale. And exhale. Settling. Open up your hips. Squeeze your heels together. Inhale. Exhale, sink a little bit lower. Pull back a little further. Follow your gaze towards the middle finger of the right hand. Inhale, flip your warrior. Boy, it's only Sunday. Breathe. Lift out of your left waistline. Don't dump into it. Inhale, straighten legs. Reach your arms forward. Take as much of a shortened stance if you need to. Right hand inside, outside, foot shin or block. Left arm in the air. Lift your heart. Breathe. Settle in your triangle. Hug your hips towards midline. Breathe in, breathe out. Big breath. Look down at your right toes. Inhale, now reverse your triangle. Arms up. Back to standing up, turn your right toes to the left. Interlace your fingers, reach your hands, wrists, forearms, elbows, or reverse prayer. Lift your chest open. Lean up and over your back, your hands. Exhale, come back through the center. Shifting your weight forward so the weight is out of your knees. Inhale, halfway lift. Release your hands under your shoulders or to a block. Bend your left knee. Any variation of Skandasana that works for you. So maybe modified like I'm doing, or maybe deeper. You may want to bind. Anything that kind of suits you. Send your weight back towards your hips or towards your heels. Some people even take a block and sit on it here, so it depends on how low you want to go this morning. Another big breath. Good. Now exhale, bend into your right leg, but turn it back around to the front of the mat. Lower your left knee to the floor. Release your toes. Good. Bring your arms on the inside of the right leg. Stay here for a moment. And then you explore where you want to go. Do you want to go deeper to your forearms? Do you want to take an arm balance? Do you want to just roll the leg open? Maybe even press it open with your hand. So this, you know, enough time here to explore different options for yourself. If your forearms are on the floor, keep them there. If you can get your forearms to the floor or block, turn your right foot forward, tuck your left toes under, and shift your weight back into a forearm plank. Shoulders on top of elbows, belly is lifted. You can have your hands in prayer or down on the floor, cross, whatever feels right for you. Inhale. Shift a little bit forward as you exhale, lower your hips to the floor. Now separate your arms, Sphinx pose. Lifting up above your belly button. Or below your belly button, above your pubic bone. Good. Exhale, push your hips back to your heels. Sit all the way back. Inhale to all fours, tuck your toes, downward facing dog, hips up in the air. Inhale your left leg in the air. Step it through. Right foot turns. I know I didn't kick it over the last time. Inhale, warrior one, rise up. Exhale, slide into warrior two, changing the direction of your hips, right? And turning the back toes a little bit forward. Front toes, knees over toes, warrior two, inhale. Exhale, settle lower. Reach back and forward at the same time. Spiral your upper thighs outward, squeeze your inner thighs inward, inhale. And exhale. Sit a little deeper. Right arm down, left arm up. Lift out of your rib cage, out of your waistline, dump into your back. Inhale, rise up. Straighten your front leg, shorten your stance if you need to. Reach forward, left hand inside, outside, foot, shin, or block. Stacking your shoulders. Externally rotating upper hip, outward, inner thigh, inward, squeeze your heels towards each other. Inhale, exhale. One more breath. Inhale, look down at your left toes, exhale, reverse it into reverse triangle. Inhale, come up, turn your left toes to the right, arms out shoulder height, and then decide, do you want to put your hands behind your back and twist your fingers or reverse your prayer? If you did something with one hand over the other, switch the side of your, maybe your thumbs or your grip. Lift your heart. Exhale, fold over into your forward fold. Softening the knees as much as you want or need to. Sending the weight a little bit forward. Let your head go, shake it out, yes, shake it out, no. Stay for a few moments. Inhale, release your hands under your shoulders, lengthen your spine. Exhale, bend the right knee, coming into your Skandasana variation that you might have taken on the other side. Binding, sitting on a block, sitting back. Any variation, hands could be at heart. So I want you to play with what you know, need today. Take another breath. Good. As you exhale, shift into your left leg, but spin it around to the front. Lower the right knee to the floor. Take your left hand on the inside. Hang out here for a moment. Just settle into it. Maybe you want to take an arm balance today. Maybe you want to come down to your forearms or a block. You can take your toes and lean onto the outer edge of your mat. Maybe take your arm to your outer or your inner thigh. So again, you know, it's really individual how we do this. Now, if you can place your arms on the floor or a block, bring them to the floor. Turn your left hip forward, tuck your right toes under, and find your way back into that side, that forearm plank. Lifting your belly, pushing your forearms down to get light. Inhale, this time I want you to lift your hips into a dolphin pose. Walk your feet a little closer towards your arms. Head is down towards the floor. Walk your feet a little closer, get your hips up, shoulders right on over elbows. And see if you want to take one leg off the floor. Some of you have a forearm balance here, so feel free to float up into that or play with getting into that. One leg in the air. And then maybe switching to the other leg, trying it a few times. If you're playing with kicking up, just open your hands a little bit. Kick your bottom heel to your buttocks as the straight leg begins to lift up. No takers, okay. So if you have one or two legs in the air, come on back down. Bend your knees to the earth. Child's pose, bring your arms by your side, head down.
Drape your shoulders open. And then roll back to sit on your heels.
Arms come all the way up. Good. Hands to prayer. Take your hands by your knees. Stay on the tops of your pedicure, on the tops of your toes. Lift your knees and shins up off the floor. Breathe. Good. Settle in. Enjoy it. One more breath. Release it. Tuck your toes underneath you. Sit back onto your heels. Lift your knees up. Walk your hands back in. Good. Now, take your hands over to the right side. Take one arm outside the left knee, one arm outside the left, I'm sorry, the right knee, the right knee and the right hip. Now, if you have the strength to keep that right arm free, keep it free. Lift your hips up, and then if not, sit on the ledge that you're creating and see if you want to take this into an arm balance, side crow. So if you're strong enough to keep your right arm free, try it. Requires more strength than I have. Breathe. If you're playing with any other variations, go ahead and play. And then when you're ready to come down, just come back into a front squatting twist and open your knees and let your arms come in between your legs and let your head hang down. Walk your hands back in. Lift your chest. And then place your hands to the outside of the left hip. Right hand by the knee, left hand by the hip. Lift your hips up. If you'd like to, bend the elbows and create a little ledge for your hips to sit on, maybe keeping the left arm free. You can, you know, you can do any kind of playing with your legs. Any variations, fallen angels, you've got chin stands, you've got twisted, yeah. So if you're flying in any variation, just make your way back down to the floor again. Open up your legs, come forward, come down this time. Maybe you come a little forward to your forearms and let your head hang down. And release your hands. Walk it back up. Walk your arms out, lift your hips. Walk back, downward facing dog. High on your toes, soften your knees, make your way to the top of your mat, halfway lift, inhale. Exhale, fold over, separate your feet hips width apart, and slide your hands all the way under your feet. Wrap your thumbs around your wrists, look forward, inhale. And exhale, let it go. Shifting your weight again, forward into the balls of your feet. Wrap your big toe around your wrist, let go. Inhale, look forward, final tug. Exhale, release your hands, lengthen your spine. Hands to hips or heart, rise up. Heel toe your feet together. Arms rest by your side. Close your eyes. Press your shoulders down and together. Press the heels and the feet evenly into the earth. Inhale, bring your arms overhead. Exhale, right arm under left. Bend your knees. Take your right leg over or double wrap. Full eagle now. We've done some chair poses, we've done some eagle arms, and now we put it together because we love it. Eagle pose. So your right foot can be on the floor, on a block, double bound, wherever your body kind of needs it to go. Now hug everything towards midline. So squeeze your knees towards center, torso towards center. If you take the variation of folding down, fold down, lift your belly up, rest your arms in front of your knees. And then inhale, come halfway up. Release your bind. Lift the right leg back in the air. Reach in two directions, forward and back. Soften your front knee. We're back to that warrior one with our eagle wrap. Inhale, the arms up. Exhale, straighten your front leg. Hang your head. Inhale, halfway lift. Turn your back foot forward, and then fold over the left leg one more time. Halfway lift, inhale. Soften your front leg, step together. Halfway lift. Exhale, let it go. Inhale, rise to stand, bring your arms with you. Exhale, hands to heart center, arms by your side. Love that line. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, left arm under right once or twice. Inhale up. Exhale, bend your knees. You can even stay here or wrap left leg once or twice around, or maybe on a block, or maybe wherever you go. If you choose to go, fold it over, elbows in front of knee, tuck the tailbone underneath you, pull your shoulders back. Get your elbows and knees lined through your center. Inhale, come up, release your left leg, float it behind you, warrior three, eagle arms. And then step into your warrior one. So your back foot turns slightly. Inhale, lift your heart. Exhale, arms come down, release, arms up. Straighten your front leg, fold over it. Ooh, excuse me. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. And then spin your back and forward. Notice the difference. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, step left to right, top of the mat. Fold as you empty. Inhale, rise to stand. Bring the arms with you. Exhale, prayer to the heart. Arms by your side. Take a breath in. Bring the arms all the way up. Exhale, fold your body in half. Halfway lift, inhale. Exhale, walk, step, hop, float back. Take a vinyasa. Upward, downward facing dogs. Hips in the air. Inhale and exhale. Good, bring your right knee to the floor. Spin onto your right side so your right hand stays down, Left arm comes up. Lift your heart up. Big stretch. Take your arm overhead. Now you can stay right where you are or slide your right leg to the left side for ball and triangle or dancer's bridge. You call it what you want. Exhale, hands to the floor. Square your hips and lower your hips to the floor. Right leg is shooting out straight from the right hip. Torso comes back towards center. Back leg is incidental. It's just hanging out for the trip. It's along for the ride. Take another breath. Okay, so now it gets tricky again. Tuck your left toes underneath you. Bring your right arm back to the floor and then pull your hips back up. Bring your left arm down, bring your right knee down, spin it forward, lift it up. Exhale, round and curl to your chin. And then release the knee to the floor. Sit back, child's pose. One more time, inhale to your knees. Take the right leg behind you. Good. Spin onto your left arm, right foot. Is down. Lifting up. Maybe your arm comes up and over. Feels really good in the side body, for me anyway. Inhale. See if you can now shoot your left leg out to the side. Lift your heart up. Right hand comes down. Square your shoulders and drop yourself into the twist. So your left leg is right up from your left hip. Turn your torso forward and let go. Back leg is just, like I said, along for the ride. Take a breath. All right, let's try and reverse it. So bring your right hand down to lift you up. Left hand on the floor. Utilize that back leg to lift you up and you're back into your side plank or your side full and triangle. Spin it back around, right arm down. Knees down to the floor, right leg in the air. Maybe your hands are down on the floor. I actually don't remember round and curl. That's my bad, huh? And then bring the knees down. Let's separate the knees wide and sit back on your heels. Take your hands in between your legs, turn your left ear to the mat. Turn the other cheek. Come left slowly to the center. Release your hands from behind or underneath you. Lift yourself up. Bring your knees together. Sit on your heels. Sit on a block if you like. Walk your hands behind you, fingers in towards you. Lift your chest up. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. Lift your heart up. Come up. Cup your heels with your hands, bring your chin to your chest, forehead to your knees, tap of the head to the floor, lift your hips up off the floor, round your pose. No weight on your head, press into the top of your foot and shins. Slowly release your hips to your heels, child's pose again. Roll up to sitting. Cross either leg in front and roll back to sit behind your legs and straighten your legs out. Shake it out, walk it up a little bit so that when you lie down on the floor, your head will be on your mat. Take a breath in. Exhale, chin to chest, round your back. Now point your toes and reach your arms towards your toes. Pull your belly up, deep, deep in. Start to roll down slowly, one vertebrae at a time. Don't skip that middle back. Good, lay on the floor, Shavasana. Arms by your side, palms up, hips open. Inhale your right knee to your chest, interlace your fingers below the knee or underneath the hamstring. Take your left hand outside right knee, right arm to the side, spinal twist. Anything you'd like to do with the top and or bottom leg. Come to your back, bring your right knee to your chest. Bend your left knee, foot on the floor. Take your right hand to your right foot, half a happy baby. Bring your right knee on the outside of your rib cage. Maybe you hold on the outside of the foot bottom or even under your thighs. And if it's safe for your back, go ahead and stretch the left leg out longer. It's your choice. So the knee pulls to the right side of your waistline rather than straight down center. Use your breath to guide you every time you exhale. Maybe you've got a little bit more space to compress into here. One more breath. As you exhale, gently release your leg and arm. Open up your arms and legs. Shavasana. Take a breath. Let it go. Inhale, left knee to your chest. Interlace your fingers below your knee, underneath your knee, or wherever else you'd like. Right hand guides the leg across the body, spinal twist. We will stay a while. Inhale back on your back, knee to chest. Bend your right leg. Take your left leg, foot towards the ceiling. Left piece finger grip, or perhaps outside your foot or underneath your thigh. Happy baby, happy baby, Ardha. Well, Ananda Balasana. Take your right leg if it feels okay on your back and straighten it out. Keep bending the left knee and work on the outside. Slow, deep, and easy breaths. Inhale through center. Exhale, release the foot, release the arms. Inhale, bend your knees, feet on the floor, heels line up with your sitting bones. Feel free to use a block for support in the bridge or come into your traditional bridge. Lift your hips up off the floor, rest on the back of your shoulders. Toes and knees point forward, heels pull back. Maybe you take your arms under your back and rest on the top of your shoulders, pushing your hips up, pressing your arms down. Didn't turn your head, just keep looking forward or close your eyes and just listen to your breath. Can you get a little bit more lift without creating the sensation of the breath or any other unfamiliar territories that you're not willing or shouldn't go to? Inhale, release the arms, upper mid, lower back to the earth. Knees come together, they knock in, and perhaps windshield wiper side to side. Let's take a second bridge, or perhaps you choose wheel or another back bend. Reaching your hands towards your heels in line with your sitting bones, tilt your pelvis, lift your hips up. Take your full wheel the way you your full bridge, or support yourself, or you can take a full wheel, fingers towards your shoulders, come to the top of your head lightly, and push up and back into a beautiful heart opening back. If you're up, stay for a few breaths before making your way down, articulating your spine, one vertebrae at a time. Come to the earth, hug the knees to the chest. Legs in the air or on a block, your legs can be elevated with your hips on a block, or you could be with your legs on the wall, legs up the wall. And just let the reversal happen here. Let your gravity and your body weight kind of sink into your pelvis. Let it reach into the floor. Slowly just bring your knees back to your chest. Full happy baby. Rock on your spine. Stay still. Hold on where you want to hold on, as long as your tailbone stays on the floor. Close your legs together. Stretch your legs out. Stretch your arms overhead. Reach all the way out from your center. Take a big breath in. And as you exhale, bring the arms back by your side. Palms open for your final shavasana. Let go. Surrender your body to the mat. Completely let go. Slowly begin to deepen your breath. If you choose to stay, just turn off the camera. Introduce small movements back to your body, fingers, toes, wrists, ankles. Make your way to either side, and through that, to a sitting position, comfortable. For a few moments, just to close the practice, bring your hands to your heart. Thank you so much for being here this morning. Thank you for sharing your energies, your passion. Thanks for your commitment. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Om peace, peace, peace to all. And now now let's all bow and honor the light, the peace, the goodness, the love within each one of us. Namaste, Satnam, and go in peace. Stay home, stay fit, stay healthy.